You thought you were done, but no, there are 35 more Windows commands you need to know. Let's get right to it. The first thing we'll do is launch our command prompt in Beast Mode, Mr. Beast Mode. So either hit Windows key S on your keyboard or click the Windows icon in your taskbar. From there, type in CMD, right click, and run as administrator. But oh, hold up, what if it just ran as administrator by default all the time? Instead of clicking run as administrator, click on open file location. There we have our command prompt shortcut. Go ahead and right click that, click on properties, advanced, and click on run as administrator by default, sucker. Click OK, apply. Okay, so now every time you run command prompt, it will default to beast mode every time. This command will help you hide all your deep dark secrets. The weird photos, the journal, everything. First, I'll take all my images and my journal and send them to a zip folder. And then with the copy command, I can hide this zip file inside a photo of a kitten. Copy /B. Specify the image, plus the name of your folder, and then the name of your new secret photo. Done. To the random person, it's just a photo. To you, it's a safe with all your stuff. With this command, we can encrypt every file in that folder so that no one can even open it if they do find it. Cipher, /E, and the folder I'm in, every file encrypted. So now only I can open these files and no one else can. This command is crazy. We can hide our folders from everyone. Like this folder here with all my secrets. Keep an eye on it, it's gonna disappear. I'll type in /attrib, +H, +S, +R, and the name of our folder. Boom, it's gone. Even we can't see it. To bring it back, just do the opposite. Change your pluses to minuses, removing those attributes and the invisibility cloak, and there it is. NetSH WLAN show profile. This command will show you every Wi-Fi network you've ever connected to. And what's even crazier is you can see the Wi-Fi passwords for every network right here in your terminal. Same command, NetSH WLAN show profile, specify the wireless network. I'll say C butterfly, and then type in key equals clear to see the Wi-Fi password in plain text. There it is, right here. If you want to see all Wi-Fi passwords for everything you have stored, this crazy command, this one-liner, will send you all of them. Now that's too much info, too much to parse through in a command prompt. What do you say we put it into a file? Let's do that same command once more, but at the very end, we'll do side arrow, I think it's what they're called, and then the name of our file, Wi-Fi passwords. .txt. And bam, all right there in a file. Austin, blur these, please. Now, you're never gonna remember that command, ever. So let's say we put it into a batch file for safekeeping. Open Notepad. I'll paste in this command, and these will all be below, by the way. File, save as, all files, and we'll call it wifi.bat. Now we just type in wifi.bat. And there they are. This is a quick way to find out all the info on your system. You simply type in system info. Like this. And it shows you your system info. SCP, or secure copy, lets you copy a file to a remote server securely. Type in SCP, the file you want to copy, and then the username and the server you want to copy to. Mine will be root at the IP address, then colon and where you want to store it on that server. Hit enter, authenticate with your password, and bam, that file is copied. I use this all the time. And I bet you didn't know this one. Check this out. Right from Explorer, wherever I am, let's say I'm in Call of Duty, I can go up to the address bar, type in CMD, and suddenly a terminal, a command prompt, and Call of Duty, just like that. That's awesome. I can also do it in reverse. Where I'm at right now in the command prompt, I'll type in Explorer, and then dot right after that, Explorer window open right where I am. That's awesome. Did you know you can map any folder on your system as a mounted drive? It's for real, check this out. The command will be SUBST, subst, and then a drive letter. Let's say S for do you want some more coffee? Don't put a colon after that. And then the location, let's just use the one we have right here. I'll put that inside quotations. And I think it did it, let's go check. Let's open up Explorer. And yeah, there it is, drive S. If I click on that, it goes right to the Call of Duty folder like I mapped it. That's so weird. You'll probably want to undo that. So the command is subst /D and then the drive letter, which was, oh, S for some more coffee. Okay, time for a quick coffee break. And this coffee break and the entire video is sponsored by IT Pro TV, which is now IT Pro from ACI Learning. Now, you're gonna need them because what I'm showing you here is just scratching the surface on IT. If you wanna get a job and change your stinking life, they've got all the training you need to start learning and growing. So I don't care if you're just getting started or you're a seasoned veteran, there are always things you have to learn because hey, we're in IT and things are constantly changing. So whether it's that first cert or you finally want to learn hacking, they've got your back. And I'm scared to say this, but you probably don't even need coffee. No, what am I saying? Of course you need coffee. But if you don't drink coffee, you may not need it. And because they're so entertaining, they won't put you to sleep. Like seriously, if you hang out with my friends like Daniel Lowry and Ronnie Wong, you're gonna have a good time. So CCNA, A+, cloud stuff, ethical hacking, they got everything. And when you're done watching, you can actually just start doing. They've got labs baked in and practice exams that'll help prepare you for exams. That's probably self-explanatory. So if you want to learn IT like me, check out IT Pro TV link below. And if you use my code NetworkChuck, you get 30% off forever. So just do it. It's cool. Coffee break over. Now it's time to make your command prompt pretty. First command is color. Type in color and just pick some random numbers like 2 and 4. Ah, no, I can't see anything. 0, 1, well, that's kind of nice. 4, 2, okay. So let me get some help here. Color /?. Ah, so here's the colors. Let's get it back. 7, 0. Nope, opposite, 0, 7. Actually, I'm gonna change it for the entire video. Let's go green on black, old school. So 2 will be green, that's the text. Black, 0, the background. Nope, I had it wrong. There we go. I spent way too long on this command. The first number is the background, second number is the text. Now we can do more to make this thing pretty. Like we can change this. Check it out. Type in prompt, bracket, hey beautiful, closing bracket, and then $G. Now that's how you have a prompt right there. Now you didn't need the brackets, but I thought it was prettier. Since we're talking about pretty, you could do it just like this, but that's not as pretty. Now if this is not your thing, just simply type in prompt, and it will reset it. Now if you want to be even more extra, because you do, and I do too, you can change the title of your window as well, for some reason. It's all for prettiness. So just type in title, and then what you want to title it. Home sweet home. Look at that, it changed the name. That's nice. How much can you curl? This next section is crazy. You ready for this? Modern Windows, like Windows 11, I think 10, has curl built in. Curl is amazing. So with the curl command, we can do things like, hey, what's the weather? We can check the weather in our command prompt. Curl WTTR-IN/where are you? I'm in Dallas. The weather right there in your command prompt. This is the coolest way to check the weather, hands down. This one's pretty cool. You can actually shorten links. See where it goes before you open it. Type in curl and a few parameters like head and location, and then the shortened URL. Just paste it in there and we'll get some info. And then because we only care about the location of it, where it's going, we'll do a bracket, type in find string, and type in location. Bam, shortened link goes here. And also you should go there and check it out, IT Pro TV. Shameless plug. You can also check the status of a website to see if it's up. Type in curl, -I, then lowercase s, and the website, networkchuck.com. Is it up right now? I sure hope so. Yeah, it is, 200 okay, which also happens to be the name of the coffee I'm drinking right now.
Wow. Oh my goodness, where do I buy some?
Curl continues. What's your public IP address? Find out right from the command line. Curl, check ip.amazonaws.com. Bam, public IP, but you can't see mine, I blurred it out. Right, Austin, you blurred that, right? Thank you. This one's kind of dumb, but it's still pretty cool. You can use curl from your command prompt to create a QR code. Type in curl and then qrenco.de and then /the website you want to make a QR code for. Let's do networkchuck.coffee. And QR code right here in your command prompt. That's just the coolest way to do it. Let's see if it works. Dude, it totally worked. That's awesome. You're welcome. Now I have good news. You no longer have to rely on YouTube to know when I upload a video. You can use the command prompt. It does everything. Back to curl. You can curl -s and then this address, which is kind of long. And then at the end, just say user equals whoever you want to see. And it will show you the latest video from your favorite YouTuber. At least the name of it, not the entire video. That'd be kind of cool. And you can even do it for Twitter. Check this out. Same story, curl -s, but a Twitter URL. And there's my latest tweet. You never ever have to leave the command line. That's the point of this video. Stay here. I told you, it's home sweet home, buddy. No, curl's not done, a few more. You can define a word. Dictionary, right in command prompt. Curl, dict.org/D for definition, colon, and then a word. Let's do the word of the day. Contretemps. An unexpected and untoward accident. Something inopportune or embarrassing. A hitch. Use it in a word. In this unhappy contretemps. I'm never gonna use that word. Now this is probably the coolest use of curl, and it's where worlds collide.
When worlds collide.
Now did you know you can use ChatGPT from the command line? This is crazy. Check this out. Now we're also still using curl. I'm gonna paste in this long command. I'll have it below. Now let's ask it a question. Who has the longest beard? And there it is right there in the command prompt. 8 feet, 2.5 inches. How do you live? Dude must know so much about IT. Now we can use ChatGPT in Windows command prompt. It's only fair that ChatGPT can then use command prompt on it, right? You can do that, by the way. Found this post on Reddit with a pretty fun prompt. Let's try it out. Okay, we got it set up. Let's see if it works. Yeah, I think so. Okay, well you can't curl. or do anything else. Busted is stupid. Here's a fun one. You can open a website right from your terminal. Just type in start, the website, and it opens. With these two commands, you can delete all the temporary files to save some space if you're running out of space. So you can download that new Call of Duty update. Run that command, and then run this command. Space restored. This one's pretty dumb and pretty fun. You may not have this command. Type in telnet and just see if you have it. Hit enter. Oh, you don't have it. Let's make sure you have it real quick. Hit Windows key S and just search for features. And click on that first option here, turn Windows features on or off. We're going to enable telnet, a very old protocol that's probably not safer to use for most things. Find telnet, click on it to enable it, click OK. It's gonna install it real quick. Done, super fast. Now if you type in telnet, it should work. How do I get out of here? Oh, just type in Q. Okay, type in Q. Took me a minute to figure it out. Now time for the fun stuff. Type in telnet and then telehack.com. Ready? Go. Now pick your poison. Like maybe you want to watch Star Wars in your terminal. Why not? Type in Star Wars. And we're just going to watch this for the rest of the video. Ah! I'm kind of into this. Okay, that's enough. Let's get out of there. I hit Control C to stop it. Let's try one more. Like aquarium.
It's aquarium right here. I mean, that's just nice to have.
Now time for the Fs. F1 through 9 can actually make you pretty awesome on your command prompt. F1 will type in each letter from the last command. It's kind of strange. That's cool though. Let me try it again with a real command. Yeah, like I don't know what the use case is for that. F2 is even weirder. So like, for example, if I type in ipconfig, that's the previous command. If I type in F2, it's gonna prompt me to copy the previous command up to a certain character. If I type in like I, it's just gonna copy some of it. I don't know, why? Comment below if you have a use case for that. I don't know. F3 is more useful. It'll copy the entire previous line. Okay, get that. F4 is weird too. If I type in ipconfig again, and I have to go to the beginning of the line, I'll type in F4 and it'll say like, where do you want to delete the character up to? Okay, let's delete it up to I. Okay, that's weird. I don't know. Again, I'm sure people like are amazing at this and find a great use case. I don't get it. F5 is pretty cool. You can cycle through previous commands. Just F5 it. Yeah, I like it. F6 enters the EOF, or the end of file indicator. That's handy for when you're typing stuff. F7 is pretty cool. It opens up a list of previous commands. Now, this is probably the coolest one here. I wanna do that one. Like, that's awesome, right? Like, okay, that's, yep. F8 will like enter the very first command you typed in ever in this terminal, or this command prompt, which apparently was CLS. And then F9 is pretty weird. It'll enter a previous command, but it'll prompt you for the number. So like, I don't know, 24. Okay, that was the 24th command I entered in this terminal. Again, weird use case. Now to get a proper list of all your commands printed out, you can do this. DOS key, /history. Everything you ever did written right here. It's pretty cool. Now this next command is gonna break your brain a little bit because what we're using right now, the command prompt, it's old news, it's stupid. I shouldn't even showed you this. The new kid on the block is terminal. Built into Windows 11, you can install it on Windows 10. We're gonna close command prompt and now search for terminal. This thing's pretty slick. You can do everything we just did in command prompt. For example, we'll probably want to open command prompt because it defaulted to PowerShell. I'll cover that in a second. Click on the little tab here and do command prompt. But that's the killer feature, right? Tabs. Oh my gosh, so cool. Now because we're in terminal, it opens up some new features we can talk about. For example, maybe you're trying to use secure copy to copy a file, but you're like, man, what's that file name? I don't know where it is. I don't want to type it out. You can just open it and explore, find it, and just drag it there. And it copies it. Could you imagine typing this out or trying to find it? That's awesome. Another cool thing is that no matter where you are in Explorer, you can shift right click a folder and say, open in terminal. And bam, there you are. If you need help, just simply ask for it. Type in help and it'll give you pretty much every command you could ever want, I think. It's a lot of them. And typing in any of these commands, like subst or start, you can do a /?, to see how to use it. This command is not one at all. It's this advice. Use this. Use PowerShell. PowerShell is better than Windows Command Prompt in a lot of ways. Now, don't get me wrong, I still use Command Prompt for a lot of things. It's just out of habit. It's what I've used my entire career. But if you want to learn anything, you want to dive deep, PowerShell is powerful. It's like Command Prompt, but better. And you can do a lot more. And to use PowerShell, it's already right here in Terminal. You can switch back and forth between, actually, Azure Cloud Shell Command Prompt and Windows PowerShell. That's the video. See you later.